Good morning, friends. I am Dr. Anirudh Vij, and today we'll be talking about the gallbladder stones, what are the causes, and how to manage them. The gallbladder is a pear-shaped organ which is located inside our abdomen on the right-hand side in the upper part, just beneath the liver. The gallbladder is a pear-shaped organ which is responsible for the storage and concentration of bile in the body. It is connected above to the liver and below to the intestine by a system of ducts. These ducts transport the fresh bile which is formed by the liver into the gallbladder, and the gallbladder fills with bile during the fasting stage. When the person takes some food, the food enters the intestine and this causes the release of certain hormones which causes the gallbladder to contract and release the concentrated bile back into the ductal system, and this ducts transports the bile into the intestine where the bile is responsible for the digestion and absorption of food. Sometimes the cholesterol within the bile gets concentrated and this leads to the formation of cholesterol stones. This can happen when the person is taking a high fat diet, is suffering from obesity or hypothyroidism, or it can happen during pregnancy due to certain hormonal changes. It can happen during the phases of rapid weight loss or fasting. The cholesterol stones form in the gallbladder and these cause blockage to the flow of bile. This leads to the symptoms of epigastric pain, bloating, intolerance of fatty food. When the stones block the flow of bile completely by getting impacted at the neck of the gallbladder, it can cause a severe pain which is located in the upper part of the abdomen, and this pain can radiate to the back or to the right shoulder also. This pain is often accompanied by several bouts of vomiting, and there can also be fever and tenderness in the abdomen. If the stone is disimpacted, then the symptoms resolve and the person can start taking food normally again. However, if the blockage continues, then the gallbladder swells up and it can become filled with mucus or even pus. Sometimes the pressure in the gallbladder builds up so much that there can be a hole in the gallbladder, and this leads to spillage of the contents in the entire abdominal cavity, and it can cause a generalized systemic infection, and this can be a deadly complication of gallbladder stones. Sometimes if the stones are small, they can pass directly into the main bile duct, and this can cause blockage of bile flow from the liver. This leads to obstructive jaundice and swelling of the liver. If the stone passes distally into the last part of the bile duct, it can even cause blockage of the pancreatic duct, and this can lead to swelling of the pancreas, which is known as pancreatitis. The diagnosis of gallbladder stones is usually made on the basis of history and clinical examination, and it can be confirmed by an ultrasound scan of the abdomen. The ultrasound scan shows that the number of stones which are present in the gallbladder, the size of the stones, their location, and whether there are any other complicating factors such as presence of swelling in the gallbladder or swelling of the liver. Ultrasound is the preferred modality of choice for the diagnosis of gallbladder stones. When the person is diagnosed to have gallstones, the treatment is by surgery. There are no medicines available either in the traditional system of medicine or in the modern day medicine which can cause dissolution of these gallbladder stones. The treatment is by surgical removal of the gallbladder itself, because if the stones only are removed, they will form again in the gallbladder and can cause recurrence of symptoms. This type of surgery can be performed either by open surgery or by laparoscopy. And these days, most of the operations are being performed by the laparoscopic route because it leads to less post-operative pain fewer blood loss and faster recovery for the patient. During surgery for gallbladder stones, a clip is placed on the cystic duct which leads to the gallbladder, and the gallbladder is cut distally and removed whole from the body along with the stones. After the surgery, the bile which is formed in the liver goes directly from the bile duct into the intestines without taking the route through the gallbladder. So the flow of bile after the surgery remains normal and the digestive power remains unaltered, which means that patients can take all types of foods even after their gallbladder surgery. This surgery is performed under general anesthesia and usually takes around 30 to 45 minutes to perform, and the patients can go home the very next day and they can perform all their routine activities within a week or so after their surgery.